So my name is Rosemarie Marchan. I am a junior group leader here at IfADo. And my background is in toxicology, but right now I lead a small research group and our interest is in cancer metabolism. And our focus is primarily on breast and ovarian cancer. So we work with a protein called EDI3. And our research over the years with this protein told us that it's important in choline metabolism. And choline is not something that most people know about, but actually it's a very important essential nutrient for us humans. And in cancer, it's been shown that choline metabolism is deregulated, especially in breast cancer. And we never really explored a role for EDI3 in breast cancer. And this is basically what started this project. We asked the question, does EDI3 and choline metabolism, what's the role of EDI3 and choline metabolism in breast cancer? And this was the basis for the project. Yeah, so breast cancer is not a single disease. It's a heterogeneous disease. And there are different types of breast cancer. And what we found that EDI3 was high in a very specific what we call subtype of breast cancer. And just for information, it's called HER2-positive, ER-negative breast cancer. And what we did, we're wondering why EDI3 is high in this subtype, if there is some survive or some advantage of having high EDI3 in this particular subtype. We began inhibiting EDI3 in these cells. So we knocked down EDI3 using RNA interference. And what we could see is that the cells basically died. And this was very specific to this particular cell type. And what we also saw, so HER2 is targeted, is a target for therapy in patients. And it's quite well established. And it's actually one of the breast cancer subtypes where there has been some success because there are medication that directly targets HER2. The problem is, of course, is that some patients, they recover or they go into regression, but later on they may develop a tumor again or develop metastasis. And a lot of times these patients become resistant to the HER2 therapies that are available. So there's always a search for alternative therapies or alternative targets in HER2-positive breast cancer. So this is where we came in. Yeah, so we saw that when we inhibited EDI3 in this particular breast cancer subtype, the cells died. And it also, the cells died more actually in the cells that were resistant to known HER2 therapy, for example, lapatinib. So this was interesting for us. So then we wanted to see, okay, this was in a cell culture dish with our cell lines. Can we transfer this to an animal model? So we also created tumors in mice that were HER2 positive, and we treated these mice with an inhibitor against EDI3. And what we could see is that actually the tumors shrunk. So EDI3 stands for endometrial protein differential 3. And it was actually identified many years ago, not by myself, but by a group of physicians looking for a marker of metastasis in endometrial cancer, actually. And what they did were they compared tumors from patients that developed metastasis from those that did not develop metastasis, and try to see, is there any differences in protein expression? And this is where they found EDI3. And then when I started working on this project, there was nothing known about this protein. So I took on the task to try and figure out what this protein does. And now, I mean, there's still a lot we don't know about it, but we do know that it is an enzyme. So basically a protein that makes a reaction go faster. And we know that EDI cleaves or metabolizes a molecule called glycerophosphocholine to produce choline and glycerol triphosphate. Of course, this probably means nothing to people who are not in the field, but these two products of this reaction is very important in different metabolic pathways. And a lot of these pathways, for example, the glycerophospholipid metabolic pathway or the choline metabolic pathway, are deregulated in different cancer types. So there's still a lot to do with this project, I mentioned that we were able to use an inhibitor to target EDI3, but this molecule that we use is not specific for EDI3. It inhibits a lot of other proteins. It's actually called dipyrimidol, and it's a general, what we call phosphodiesterase inhibitor that's actually used in stroke patients in the hospital. And there have been some studies trying to use this in different tumor types, but none yet in HER2 breast cancer. So this was kind of promising for us. But what we would really like to have is a specific inhibitor against EDI3. And this is something we will do in the next year to try and use what's called a small molecule library or a chemical library to see if we do a screen that we can find a specific inhibitor against EDI3. And then, of course, we'll do the same experiments again. The other question that we would like to answer is we always have the question, how is EDI3 regulated? So right now we have a nice situation where we have cells where EDI3 is high. And the HER2 signaling pathway, it's very specific. And we know some of the proteins that are involved in this signaling pathway. So our next step is to try and figure out what part of this pathway is important for regulating EDI3. So this is a huge other part of the project. We also have patient samples from our collaborators in Mainz and at the University Clinic in Mainz. And what we would like to do, because these patient samples, these tumor samples, which is quite precious, they represent the different molecular subtypes, including our HER2-positive, ER-negative subtype. So the idea is, in-house, we are able to do metabolomics and proteomics. So the idea would be to look at the different metabolites in these tumors and the different proteins in these tumors to see, does it match what we see so far with regard to EDI3? Is EDI higher in this tumor type or this subtype of breast cancer? And what are the metabolic differences between these different subtypes? And can we probably, of course, this is hopeful thinking, but probably find not only EDI, but probably other targets in this, let's say, in this very rare or less often subtype of breast cancer. So one of the other ideas that we have and we would like to do is there are mouse models. So far what we did was we took cells and we made tumors in mice. There are mouse models available that spontaneously produce tumors. They're transgenic mice. And there is a mouse model that makes or produces HER2-positive, ER-negative tumors and then metastasis. So this is more similar to the patient situation. Rather than us introducing the tumor, the mice actually produce tumors, and not all the mice produce tumors. So sort of really mimicking the human situation. And the idea would be is hopefully it takes half a year to get these tumors. So the idea is hopefully we would also have an inhibitor against EDI, and we can then treat these mice and see if by treating these mice with this very specific HER2-positive ER-negative tumors, we are able to decrease tumor growth or probably metastasis. And this would be a really nice validation experiment for what we've done so far. Yeah, so I know it's a long way off, but our results are really encouraging. And I hope in a few years, we're able to say that we have provided an alternative target for HER2 patients that are resistant to the current therapies that are available.